How's it guys, Munash here, and today it saddens me to say that I've been exposed. And by exposed I don't mean I've been caught in 4K in the latest YouTube scandal or drama. No, I just mean that my identity has been compromised or revealed to a certain someone that you might have heard of. And of course I'm talking about the Mcoc merc, you know, goat of Mcoc, allergic to using full stops to separate his sentences, yeah, same guy. So long story short, he ended up finding out about this whole thing, and I guess he wasn't very pleased by it. Which we'll get to a bit later, but first we're actually gonna carry on from where we left off. So the last message I sent to him was me saying it's probably better to stay away from the legend run after what happened with Act 7. Just being a bit more real with him, so I was quite curious to see how I would respond to this, and of course he had a lot to say. Yeah. He then asks me, so what do you want me to do? And at that point I was thinking of saying, retire, maybe? Not from the game, but from this whole merking business, just cause, you know, it's kind of against the rules, TOS and all that. And the thing is, he is way too good at this game, so Kabam is getting all this data of people clearing Abyss for less than 1,000 units, so the devs might think they made it a little bit too easy now that people are clearing it with less than 1,000 units with nothing but rank 5 5 stars. Meanwhile, it's just the Mcoc merc doing it all by himself on several different accounts, and he is just so good that he brings the base average to quite a high level, so Kabam will actually get influence and try to make content even harder in the future. All because of this one guy who's just clapping content like he claps cheeks left and right, making an absolute mockery of the Abyss. But back to the question, so I wasn't quite done clowning on him just yet. So I responded by saying just do uncollected, you know, but first I wanna see proof, you know, to make sure that you actually are legit since you claim it so much. And to make sure I don't get banned or anything like that. So again, I was quite curious to see how I would respond to this, like how I would actually display his evidence. And quite frankly, I was disappointed. He basically did the bare minimum. All he did was provide me with screenshots of past conversations with these so-called clients. Which of course can be faked, I mean it's not that hard to create a second account and just text yourself. Or just get one of your mates involved so you only need to have one account. Or you could go the editing route with Photoshop or something like that. But I doubt he would actually go through such lengths, especially considering how good he is. So I just assumed they're all real, cause they probably are. The thing that surprised me the most about these screenshots is that they were completely unedited. I'm the one who covered up the names. He on the other hand made no effort whatsoever to hide the identity of these people. And I was kind of stunned by that, cause I thought confidentiality is a big part of this business, but apparently not, or maybe it's just for him. I thought these people might not appreciate him doing that, but maybe they don't care. Maybe they're all just ignorant to this whole thing, cause he might actually think that he's genuinely doing a good job and helping people, and might even think that there's nothing wrong at all with what he's doing. But revealing contact details is just a rookie mistake. If I were doing a review, I would have to deduct some points for that. Still a 10 out of 10 in the skill department, but the administration and the way you communicate with your clients in general is not very good. I mean, no full stops, constantly having to repeat myself, lack of confidentiality, but on top of all that, the worst one for me, and this was by far the worst one, was just the blatant disregard for my question about the hippies. To this day, I still don't know what he charges for throwing stones at hippies at a farmer's market, and I must say, it is killing me on the inside. Now I kind of need to find a new fun family activity for my little brother's birthday party. So after he sends me the screenshots... Oh, I don't respond. Did I go to sleep or... Oh, I must have been working on the previous video at that time. Then I uploaded it and then I went to sleep. So I wake up the next morning and see this message from this guy saying, oh, so you think it's funny to make a video about when you don't know who I am or anything mate, nice on I'm actually a nice guy. And you're just a prick, mate. Man, I feel like I lose a brain cell every time I read one of this guy's paragraphs. I mean, would it kill you to use a full stop every once in a while? At least proofread the damn thing, but whatever. So I guess between me uploading the previous video and him typing out this disabled message, he found out that I made a video about him. So yeah, the jig is up, I've been exposed, and I don't know what I'm gonna do about it. Might need to move to a new country and change my name because the Mcoc merc knows. So I might just move to Guatemala and start calling myself Alejandro or something. But then I have to learn a new culture and blending in might not be very easy. Maybe I'll go to Hawaii instead because that's the antipode of South Africa, so it's a little bit further at least. Yeah, no, but seriously, I just want to know how he actually found out. because I figured he would have found out a lot sooner than he actually did, considering that my YouTube link is on my profile. So maybe he decided to actually check it and then he saw the link and watched the video. Or maybe somebody just told him about it, I don't know. But the main thing is he saw it and he did not like what he saw. I was looking forward to responding to him, but unfortunately he left the chat before I got a chance to, which I guess just means he blocked me because it's a one-on-one chat. Apparently he also changed his name after blocking me. He's no longer going as Mcoc Merc. I don't know what he's going as now. He could actually be TittyBoy69 for all I know. But either way, I can't really contact him anymore. So unfortunately, I missed out on that. Was having quite a busy morning that day. But what I would have said is, yes, I do find it quite funny to make a video about this whole thing. That is why I made it in the first place, for fun and entertaining people. So he claims to be a nice guy and calls me a prick, which I guess is fair enough. I mean, I think it's a reasonable response to have after getting trolled like this. And you'd think after sending a message like that and then blocking me, that'll conclude this saga, right? Yeah, no, cause wait, there is more. This is not the only way he responded to me. He actually did also comment on the video itself, where he had much more to say. I guess after watching the video, he had a much better picture or understanding of the whole thing, which does tend to happen when you actually watch the video before commenting, you know, gain some knowledge and context first. So he commented with the exact same style he uses online. No full stops, just one giant paragraph, and I really don't want to read this. I mean, at this stage, it's more like a short essay, but... Okay, it's me, Mcoc Merc. It was late at night, mate, and yeah, I was busy, and yeah, I kept repeating myself because I don't really like doing event quests. I'm into the hard stuff also. I said I can get it done with 600 units. Yes, because I got close to doing it with that and like a challenge. It's more up to 800 to 1200. You can make a video about me all you want. I'm only a merc because I'm 16 and hardly have any money. And I have to pay for things on my own. And I did send screenshots of my proof, which you removed me before you got to see it. Actually, I did get to see them. You're the one who removed me. You left the chat, which I assume is just you blocking me. I didn't do anything. But yeah, anyway, then he says, and yes, I don't have a clue who you are. So there's a lot to unpack here, but before we get into that, I'm gonna read his next comment, because he did comment again, with another paragraph, completely void of any full stops. Also, I would like to say that I actually enjoyed this video. I've never heard of you, and I actually enjoyed watching this video, and all I want to do is help people out. They help me... I'm a bad person. What? Is he trying to say, but hey, I'm a bad person? No, but that doesn't make sense. But they think, but hi, they egg him. I don't even know what I'm saying at this point. I'm gonna stop trying to decipher this nonsense. But then he says, I'll drop a like on this video because it was actually entertaining. Thank you, Mr. Mcoc Merc. So at least he does have a sense of humor, I guess, or doesn't take things too seriously. And we got to find out a little bit more about our friendly neighborhood Mcoc Merc. Now we know his age and his motives. A 16-year-old just trying to make some extra money to get by, I guess. At least that's what it sounded like to me. And like I said in the previous video, usually I can respect the hustle sort of mentality, but at the same time I can't respect breaking terms of service. It's quite unfortunate that he blocked me though, because I would have carried on speaking to him and probably given him some advice. He's made some mistakes, but I rate I could have steered him onto the right path to salvation. Maybe even help him start his own YouTube channel, because I mean, if he can do a burst path in about 600 units... Oh wait, I think he changed it in one of the comments. Okay, so he said 600 because he got close the one time, and he likes the challenge, but realistically it's more like 800 to 1200. But that is still a very impressive unit cost for any Abyss path using the Horseman as maxed 5 stars. I would have loved to see some Abyss gameplay from this guy. He probably would have put Swedia and MSD to shame. And I'm sure he has a lot of tricks and tips he could have shared with the community to help make a lot of us better players. And maybe one day with enough practice, blood, sweat, tears, and semen, maybe one day we will be able to be half as good as he is. And boy will we rejoice when that day comes, heralding him as the true Mcoc legend, god, king, whatever you wanna call it. The point is, he could have been immortalized. But no, he just had to block me, and the worst thing about all of this is that now I'll never know how much he charges for throwing stones at hippies at a farmer's market. And that about wraps up today's episode of To Catch a Merc, and... I feel like I need to say and make this very clear, but I am joking about all this. I'm not actually trying to actively go around catching mercs and all that. This is just a fun video made for entertainment purposes, and hopefully you guys enjoyed it. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this one. Thank you for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you soon.